Coming up next, we have another installment of the Beat Diaries, which are profiles of young people just getting out of juvenile hall or YA or the juvenile justice system. Comes out of The Beat Within, which is a sister publication of ours. You know, they do workshops in juvenile halls that go in, you know, all around nine county Bay Area, and conduct writing workshops, get youngsters to tell their own stories, and put out like a weekly newsletter with what everybody else has written. And this is kind of like the video version, telling people stories coming out of the system. And this week we have Geanice, right?
Mm-hmm. Geanice is gonna tell you about how, she kind of comes from a shaky background where a lot of her family members have already been in jail. She got locked up because she got into a fight and busted one on the girl. But anyways, she is taking anger management classes, trying to better herself, but you get to hear her story.
I mean, a lot of things happen over here. Not necessarily killings and stuff like that, but I mean, a lot of people have went to jail over here and things like that. My auntie, man, she stayed locked up for all kinds of things. She real violent. She likes to kidnap people, hold them hostage and stuff like that. My daddy had been to jail before. My mama been there before. My cousin Bug, he stayed getting locked up. Matter of fact, he in Santa Rita now because he just turned 18. I basically know a lot of people that been to jail before. This girl has stole my money out of my purse. I told the teacher about it. She didn't do nothing, so I took it in my own hands and I asked her about it. She started laughing. I didn't like the answer she gave me, so we started fighting. I said I wasn't gonna go to juvenile hall, and I have went there. She went to the hospital or whatever. They said she was unconscious for approximately 5 minutes. I got took in the juvenile hall, and the girl that stole my money didn't get any consequences. And they trying to make her out to be the victim. I got kicked out. I went to juvenile hall for 2 weeks. And then I was on house arrest for about a month. Now I'm on probation. I got to do anger management. I did community service already, and I had to take a cop class. I don't feel I need anger management classes. I know I get upset at times, but I don't think that it's that serious for me to be having to take anger management. I think I was just upset because she stole my money, and I really believe that I was supposed to be. I don't think that nothing I did was wrong, and I'm not sorry for it. I'm sorry if she got injured badly, like they trying to say she did, but I'm not sorry for what I did and why I did it. Since I've been out, I think that my parents encouraged me to get a job and things like that, and to go to school and graduate and all that. But I believe that a lot of it came from me, just wanting to go to school and just wanting to get a job to have my own money and things like that. I have a side hustle, which is braiding.
I've been braiding for 5 years, since I was in the sixth grade.
I used to always like to braid, so I used to braid my baby doll's hair or whatever. And when I was attending Frick Junior High, a lot of my friends liked the work that I did and asked me to braid their hair. So I started off braiding a lot of people's hair for free just to practice and stuff. If I was to work in the shop, I would have to rent a booth and pay them for letting me work in their shop and all that. And all that, and I don't think all that is necessary when I could just braid at my house. After I was released, they told me that I'm not supposed to be by San Leandro High. I got to be like 200 yards or 200 feet away from there. Before I went to juvenile hall, I was a good student. I was an honor roll student. I mean, I never really got in trouble. Right now, I attend Rockland Flesh Community Day School. It's basically like a high school. The only difference is they don't have honors classes and dances and things like that. I think this incident has affected my education a lot because, like, when I went to San Leandro High School, I had 2 honors classes, and I was doing very good in them, but now it seems like since I'm at Rockland Flesh, it seems like I'm behind, and when I go back, I'll be behind. In a few months, I will hope to tell you guys that I'm off probation and that I'm bonding with my family more, still maintaining all A's, but I would like to be in a regular high school.